1986, Lake Huron, the second largest of the Great Lakes. Shipwreck hunters are exploring the waters in the northwest of the lake when they make a jaw-dropping discovery. A schooner, more than 100 years old, frozen in time on the lake bed.
She is completely intact.
The masts are still up. The rings that hold the sails that go up the mast are still in place. The cargo of grain is still in the hold. I mean, this vessel is in pretty spectacular condition.
It was almost as if it had been sort of gently placed on the bottom of the lake.
How is it that this great ship is pristine, in condition, resting on a lake bed?
On the ship's side, divers discover a name, the Cornelia B. Windiatt. She's a 136-foot schooner that went missing with all hands during the November storm season of 1875.
The Great Lakes take their fair share of ships.
6,000 shipwrecks litter the beds of these huge lakes, and over 30,000 lives have been lost.
If a vessel's in a storm, usually that storm creates havoc on the vessel. You know, it can rip things off the deck, tear things apart, bust masts, things like that. None of that is seen on the Windiatt.
If that ship had sunk in a storm, you'd expect it to be smashed to pieces.
As well as no signs of damage, there are no signs of any crew.
We don't know where the crew are. There are no bodies associated with it at all.
But we do know that they didn't make a standard maritime escape. Lying in perfect condition on the lake bed is the schooner's single lifeboat. What happened to the Windiatt and her men?
One thing is certain, the ship sank. Why or how it sank is a little bit more unclear.
In the 1870s, Lake Huron was part of a valuable grain route.
We know the vessel left Milwaukee loaded with tons of grain. She was heading to Buffalo, one of the great grain centers on the eastern Great Lakes.
A November sailing carried weather risks. But with fewer voyages being undertaken at this time of year, it's likely there would have been a financial incentive for the crew.
The area depends on this kind of trade, and there would be nothing worse than a bunch of rotting grain, especially at the end of the season.
It appears that the Windiatt was leaving nothing to waste. Port records show that on departure, she was overloaded with 30% more cargo than usual. During her voyage, the Windiatt would likely have encountered gale force winds and temperatures down to minus 10 degrees or colder. So is it possible that the freezing weather provided an unexpected escape route for the missing crew?
Because it was cold weather, perhaps the ship itself got stuck into ice and the crew tried to leave the ship.
Such an escape is not without precedent. In winter, the Great Lakes are prone to freezing, and thick ice could have provided a route to shore. But one piece of evidence suggests the Windiatt crew did not simply walk off the ship.
Now, the lifeboat has been left behind. Knowing that the ice is sometimes treacherous, you would have expected them to have possibly taken the lifeboat with them.
And the latest analysis of wind directions suggests that a significant lake freeze didn't happen in this period. So getting stuck seems unlikely. And even if that did happen, the force of ice crushing it from all sides would be evident on the Windiatt's remains, which are undamaged. But could a much more recent tragedy on the high seas provide a new lead in solving this puzzling mystery? 2017, the Bering Sea. In the northern Pacific Ocean. Seattle-based crab boat, The Destination, sails into severely cold and rough conditions.
They didn't even have time to react. before the vessel capsized and sank. 6 people were killed.
A key cause of the sinking was found to be a buildup of ice on the boat.
In very cold conditions, when you have waves and you have spray, the spray will turn into ice droplets and start to cover things with ice. It just builds up layer after layer, wave after wave comes crashing in until it reaches a point where it just overtakes the vessel.
The Windiat was a sizable vessel capable of carrying large quantities of heavy cargo. So could ice really have taken her down?
With the weight of ice on the top of the vessel rather than at the bottom of the vessel, you have these huge issues with weight distribution. And when the vessel goes over, there's no righting moment from the bottom of the vessel to stop that ice from pulling down. Gravity is actually working against the vessel.
And in the fresh waters of the Great Lakes, another factor would have been working against the Windiat.
Fresh water would freeze quicker than salt water. If you're in a very cold saltwater environment, you can have temperatures of -2 degrees, and it doesn't freeze. If you're in the Great Lakes, which is fresh water, there is a possibility of having that ice build up just from the wind.
As we're able to explore the polar regions more and more, this problem of sea icing is extremely perilous for ships. And finding ways to quickly remove the sea ice is one of the holy grails of navigation and shipping and oceanographic research in terms of keeping vessels and crews safe in these extreme conditions.
Solutions are out there.
There are a couple of strands currently being sought for how to solve icing on ships. Some have looked at the idea of heating decks rather like you have heated floors in some people's kitchens. Others have looked at special paints which will stop the ice sticking and make it slide away. And more are looking at potential options for weather prediction so we can have a better idea of where this is likely to occur.
So being able to predict when sea spray icing will be a real problem is very valuable because the conditions have to be just right in terms of the temperature, the wind speed. And so as our meteorological and oceanographic prediction improves, this is going to really help with the safety of these vessels and crews in these polar regions.
But for now, it seems the main defense against ice buildup is a hands-on approach.
The only kind of defenses that crews have is going out and actually breaking it off by hand, using hammers, wedges, anything they have to kind of beat back the ice and outrun Mother Nature itself.
And spray ice on the decks may account for another element in the Windiat mystery, the missing crew.
You're on a moving ship. The crew would have been sliding across it.
Meaning that they were actually washed off the ship. The spray, which was adding ice to the ship, actually got rid of them.
Whether or not the ice sent the crew sliding to their deaths, it may have played an even more surprising role. It could be responsible for the remarkable preservation of the Windiat wreck.
So when it's covered with the ice, that adds enough weight to sink it. But the ice, of course, is also slightly buoyant. So that is why she ends up having a nice, smooth glide to the bottom of the seabed. In fact, she might have even sat there suspended in the water for a bit.
The ice just melts away and boom, you have your perfect ship at the bottom of a lake bed.
And this is how she was found, over 100 years later. But there's no way of knowing for sure that ice was what sank the ship.
The trouble is, there'll be nothing for us to discover that proves the ice, because the ice, of course, is mostly made up of the water which has existed around the Windiat now for hundreds of years. So it's a theory.